right off the hop.
Uncharacteristic serve of Jha. He does not like to serve deep very often. He chose to do it the very first point. I love that.
I've heard that he will do that to set a message to his opponents to almost like keep them on guard. It was a great serve.
Hey!
I'm very vocal winning his first point of this match. Very pumped up to try to get off to a good start.
Let
serve one there. So do that one again.
Here come the receives of Jha. He's an excellent receive of server. Look at that great short return. Nice shot by Jha there. And it was set up with that great receive mark. He was able to come in and cut that ball off the bounce, put it short, which then set up this beautiful forehand down the line.
Yeah, and that wasn't easy, Jimmy, because that serve had a ton of juice on it when it came over to Jha.
Oh, fantastic backhand misdirection down the line. Again, that whole point started with a beautiful receive from Jha. Jha makes the receive game look easy, but anyone that's been out on the table, it's one of the hardest aspects of the game, reading the spin.
Good job there by Jha, defending off a shot. By An, a lot of power on that shot, but Jha was able to get it back on the table and on hit into the net. A 4-1 early lead here for the American Canuck Jha from Milpitas, California.
Cut. Oh. Yeah. 2-4.
By the body that time, difficult to handle for Jha.
Exactly, An trying to open into Jha's body. Jha has an excellent backhand, and so you are going to see An try to pin him to the middle or forehand side as much as he can when Jha is close to the table.
It's interesting, he served long that time, long and fast to Jha, difficult ball to handle, almost like, you're gonna do that to me, I'm gonna do it to you.
Exactly what I do when someone does it to me, just give it to him back. I say, great idea, and I do it back.
Nice backhand that time by Canuck Jha. Deep on the table with some good spin. And Jha has a 5-3 lead here in game one. As noted, a best of seven in the singles.
Six.
Beautiful shot. The loop down the line that time by Jha. Right on the tape, on the edge of the table.
Fantastic step around. Can't do it any better than that, Mark. Mm.
Three, seven.
So it's really the change of pace of the ball that has really given Jha the lead. He's put in a couple fastballs, but he's really good at playing slow. He's really good at placement. He's really good at consistency.
Nice return that time by you talking about his return of serve. That was a beautiful one. Cross court with excellent touch. And An hit it long. And now an 8-3 lead for Canuck Jha in game one.
Well, that's just too good from An there.
Nice backhand. Had a lot of pace on it. They go to the towel break. Every 6 points in table tennis, you're allowed to take a towel break, and both players go over to the towel this time. But that's just a beautiful backhand, Jimmy.
Perfection. Now, one thing about Jha, his service game is not as strong as his receive, so you won't see the opponent miss many of his serves. They're pretty simple. Oh, my goodness.
Five.
That was smoke right there on the backhand. Good. Wrist movement that time by An Jae-hyun of Korea. A lot of power.
Six.
So what happened there was An had problems with Jha's receive and popped it up. However, that surprised Jha. You don't expect someone to pop the ball up high. You're always ready for a good receive. caught him off guard. He needs to make that shot, but that's why he missed it. He wasn't ready for such a poor receive.
Let 6, 8.
Drawing himself back into this game is An Jae-hyun of Korea. Run off four consecutive here now at 7-8 with the serve, game one.
Mark, that's the first receive. Ja has missed this game. So unable to get an unforced error off his serve for the first time at a very important point of this game. Ja desperately needs a point right now to stop the bleeding. It's a bad feeling when you start losing 3-4 points in a row.
That's how you do it right there, Jimmy. Beautiful backhand punch by Tanak Ja. And An came across nicely to get there, but hit it long.
Well, I love the risk that Ja took on the serve. He's going to have to take some risks to win this game, and that was a risk, and it paid off.
To even at 9, here's Ja's shot goes long.
That was an unfortunate miss by Ja there. He was in control of that point. He got the shot he needed, but you can tell there's some cobwebs on him right now. It's the first game. Both players must be feeling some nerves. Great receive.
Right two off the top of the net, but you're right, Jimmy. That ball, the serve that time by An, had tremendous movement on it, and Ja did a great job of adjusting it, getting on the table. Game point for Tanak Ja here, game one of this round of 128 men's singles. Two young stars, upcoming stars.
Good receive.
And there it is, off the net and out. And again, Ja's receive, as you predicted, Jimmy. And An starts this game with the serve. Tremendous movement on that serve. Great camera work showed us the ball as it was spinning for us looking at it left to right. And Ja just went off the edge of the paddle and way wide. Tough ball to handle off the top of the net. You're going to have difficulty there, and Ja unable to handle that. And an early 2-0 lead for An Jae-hyun.
Excellent short game there by Ja. He's so good short. He's so good on the receives. He can cut you short. He can get that banana backhand flick in when you play short. He's the better of the two athletes, short to short.
Forehand loop that time from An. Lots of power on it. Ja went with a real high toss serve that time. An was able to handle it. A little self-talk there to get himself going, but that shows you the power of the Korean youngster. An Jae-hyun, only 21 years of age.
So that's something that An can do that Ja can't do as much. An can finish the point on you early because of the power and the speed of his legs, demonstrating it the last 2 points. Beautiful get there by Ja. Reacted to the deep serve. I don't think he expected it, but he reacted to it perfectly. And to take it down the line when you're not expecting it just shows how good he is in the receive game.
No way that An was getting that ball. That was right on the corner, and you can tell by his reaction. He did not expect that shot.
He's wondering how that happened. That's not a normal receive there when you're not expecting it. Great defense there by An. Ja showing us some power there on that opening backhand with a quick flick of the wrist. Generated some super heat.
right into the body of On Two, and he was able to handle it well. It's up 5-2 here in game two. So by Ja's reaction there, he thought he had good positioning to get that ball on the table. Unfortunately, it went wide for him, and now it's a 6-2 lead for On Jae Hyun.
And there's Un demonstrating his short game. He's able to get Ja to pop that ball up, and then the speed of his legs. Watch the step around, and it's finished. That's just tremendous power.
Yeah, he's got good body mechanics there on that step around drive.
There you go.
Three, seven. Go.
Ja able to get a quick point there off the receive. That's so helpful when you're down. You kind of hope your opponent gives you a couple points that you for free, or at least some quick points to try to help you get back in. It's such a long way back when you're down 7-2. Nice serve and followed by Ja. It was the no spin serve that got On to pop it up. On thought it had more spin than it really did. And then a nice forehand flick to finish the point.
Goes long, so Ja fighting back from a 7-2 deficit, now within two at 5-7. Has a couple of good strikes by both players in that sequence. And On the final backhand just goes too far.
But Ja just played with more speed than On that point. And backhand to backhand, Ja is the favorite.
Positioning that time by Ja.
That ball caught the edge of his racket. That's why you see him apologize. It hit the edge of his racket, which threw off On. So a bit of good fortune there on that receive. And just like that, Mark, Ja only down a point this game.
Great shots by Ja, but unable to finish on the last one. He went way wide on the forehand side.
Watch this right here. Best point of the match. Ja comes close to the table, but then steps around. And oh, notice how he shows that his arm went up. He lost his technique there, and he was kind of smiling at himself.
A couple of beautiful shots by On on the backhand there, Jimmy. Just deep off the table, was able to get those back on.
Great job by On hanging in that point. Ja had him pinned backhand to backhand. Watch Ja go to the forehand, and On is ready for it.
Good look at his footwork there, too, for On, how quickly he was able to get over to that ball on the forehand.
Oh, that's just beautiful play by On. What a great change of pace stop block he made. Ja only able to push it back, and then he comes in with that beautiful, powerful forehand.
Switched him up too, went down the backhand side. I don't think he was expecting that. Long, so Ja staves off one game point here in game two. It's within three. Leading one game to none, the American Canuck Ja, number one American player in this tournament, in the country. Oh, beautiful backhand down the line that time. On was committed to what would be his left, deep on the left side. This is a difficult ball to get to.
On wanted to step around, so you see him back up, and Ja saw that.
Wide open.
Went down the line immediately. No one home.
serve comes over to Kanakja. 21-year-old from Milpitas, California, down by two here in game two. There's another game point against.
Great job by Jock, putting the ball on the table, not taking any big risk there. Anytime I'm at the end of a game, 9-all, 10-all, I like to play consistent and put the ball on the table and force my opponent to make quality shots through me. I learned that from a great Chinese player named Chen Yinghua, and it's a strategy that's worked my whole career. You saw him do it there. Let's see what he does this point. Big point.
Oh, so Job brings it back to even, staves off five consecutive game points here, and now finds himself in a 10-10 tie in game two. As you noted, Jimmy, that was a critical point, and here comes another one.
Big comeback, but it's important to remember that it's still even, so John needs to keep his focus, keep his intensity. All that work, and we're back to even.
Sound like that came off the edge of Jaws' paddle and went long. And another game point here for An Jae-hyun.
Watch this push. It's the length of the push that got Ja. That ball hit the white line. It was a perfectly executed push by An.
Game two does go to On. Round of 128, men's singles. Kanakja of America just serving and winning the first point in game three against young Korean star An Jae-hyun, who took game two, but Ja comes out and gets on the board first here in what is a critical game three in a best of seven.
One on.
And that's one of the worst mistakes of the match by Ja, and I say worst mistakes. He missed that by a mile. It's interesting. An opened up and gave him no pace to work with, and it totally messed up his timing.
Oh, that's a great shot from Ja. Backhand to the backhand side of An. Actually, it was to his forehand side, and it went off the edge of the paddle. Beautiful shot that time by Ja. Retakes the lead at 2-1.
Let. 1-2.
Oh, beautiful receive by Ja there.
One.
Coming like he hit that flat, Jimmy, like he just came straight across and pulled it right across the body.
Yeah, it was an inside-out forehand flick coming across the body, something we haven't seen him do this match. Totally caught on off guard.
Three, two.
Back right there for Jaws. It went off the top of the net long. Put one real good shot into the body of An there, but An has a certain quickness where his ability to adjust to the balls coming into him, very strong in that capacity.
Three.
That ball clipped the top of the net from An. Fortunate break for him. It's standard in table tennis that when a ball hits the top of the net or the edge, you'll see the athletes put their hand up. It's a form of saying, I was lucky. It's a form of respect.
We heard Ja do the same thing there because his shot went off the top of the net. Difficult for An to respond. Very interesting serve that time by An. It was kind of the almost like a pendulum swing down deep in his body, a different type of serve, a different type of spin that Ja had to handle.
Four, oh.
An so quick with his legs. That was such a quick backhand there. I thought Ja made a nice, formidable shot, and An jumped back with his legs and just played it so quick.
Pinnock talking with one of the umpires here is obviously not sure what was got his ire there, but pointed back towards the stands for some reason or other.
Ball five.
So that was a nice off-timed receive there. An took the receive off the bounce. That's what messed up the timing of Ja at that point.
A soft touch by both players, but An was able to reach out over the table on the deciding strike and drive it behind Ja and take a 2-point lead here in game three. There's that long pass serve, Jimmy, and Ja did a good job of handling it, but from that point forward, you felt like that An was in control at that point, and now has opened up a 7-4 lead here in game three.
Ja showing a little frustration there. He's made some unforced errors this game. Definitely out of rhythm. And you'll see the reaction here. He misses that shot and the frustration.
It's Pinnock Ja, a two-time Olympian. In 2016, he represented the United States of America in Rio as the youngest American on the team. A little bit lucky there on the let serve. Obviously, if the serve hits the net and lands in play, that's a let serve.
You can be almost sure he'll serve short now because it gave away his deep serve, too. It worked out real well. Yeah. And what worked there is he served wide out to the unbackhand, which we haven't seen. It's customary in table tennis to serve short to the opponent's forehand. That is the weakest point of the table. But that time he went wide to his backhand, caught him off guard. Great decision.
Great exchange between the two players, and it's Ja who drives it in the net, and it's An who picks up the point, and now has a 4-point lead here in game three at 9-5. Real nice power exchange between the two. Ja, as you noted, probably the stronger player on the backhand side, and was stuck with that, but ultimately into the net.
There's that off-pace, slow backhand opening by An. A lot of people feel, you know, speed wins in table tennis, and it does, but it's the slow off-pace shots that can also get you a lot of points.
That is game three in favor of An Jae-eun. In our coverage here, we've got the American Pinnock Ja down to the Korean player An Jae-eun.
Interesting start. We've seen both athletes serve deep the very first point, three out of these four games.
Good job by Ja. Going off the top of the net into the body of An, and Ja opening up a 2-0 lead here. And what you think has got to be a critical game for Jimmy. I mean, you're down now 2-1. And the momentum has clearly shifted in favor of the Korean An. So for Ja, this seems to be an important part of the match.
Well, my answer to that. There's only one thing that's worse than being down 3-0, and that is 3-1. So very important for Ja. It does not feel good to be down 3-1. You don't come back from that very often. This is a really good start for him this game.
One, three.
So it's going to be really important for Ja to eliminate those kind of unforced errors. That's one of his strengths. He doesn't miss those kind of balls very much, and his game is such where he can't afford those misses. Those kind of misses. He can't afford to make those kind of mistakes. And when he's playing his best, he doesn't make those kind of mistakes very often. It's very important for him to get that short up this game, if possible, to get him back into this match.
Great response that time by An. It looked like Ja was going to be able to put him away. And An was able to get across on the forehand, get it back on the table, win the point, and tie things up at 3-3. Three consecutive points for An Jae-hyun.
An is so fast on his feet. Just makes some of this stuff look so easy, but you can't do that unless you have that kind of foot speed. Oh, what a great reaction by An. Ja looked like he was in command of that point. And just the here we go again. A nice backhand, and An just waiting for it. Takes that ball down the line. Excellent serve by Ja. I love the amount of deep serves we've seen from him this match. I am a big supporter of the deep serve. Whether you win the point or not, it keeps your opponent honest from coming in with those strong banana flicks. You've got to make your opponent think you might serve deep any point and every point. Excellent serve there. That ball was loaded with heavy chop.
Evens it up again as that ball goes off the net and long. This will be an interesting decision on the serve for him here, Jimmy, at 5-5 in game four. He went back to that long, fast serve. It worked out for him, but it was because of his backhand loop. Good power on that backhand by Ja. It seems when the players do get into the backhand exchange that Ja is the stronger player. Two smashes by Ja there and finishes on the second.
Great job by Ja finishing that point. Some people might say, well, that ball's easy, it's high. That is not one of Ja's strengths. When a player goes back and puts a nice, spinny, high arc on the ball, he's not always good at finishing those balls. That was a great job by him finishing that ball to go up 7-5 this game.
The edge of the table that time. Draw back within one for An. You can tell, as Jimmy's noted, that there is the courtesy and respect element of kind of acknowledging that there's some fortune there, but still a point. Great job by Ja that time down the line with that backhand punch. And he got over to the ball, An did, but was unable to get it back on the table.
Well, An wanting to go around on the forehand, Ja sees that and immediately takes him down the line, a shot he's so good at. That inside-out backhand down-the-line loop, Ja so good at it.
It was a great camera look, too, because you could see how much curve there was on that ball after it was struck by Ja.
Great job by Ja hanging in that point. That ball popped up on him, but An decided not to punish him. Played it safe, cost him the point. Ja came in and took advantage.
And An showed a little bit of frustration there, so we haven't seen much of that yet. Ja up by three now.
Oh. Excellent point, Mark. Josh playing one of his best points of the match, really showing a display of touch and power, but unable to hang in the point. And right there, that ball goes off the top of the net for Ja.
Great return of service that time by Ja. Put on the defensive, and Ja was able to finish him and draws to game point now at 10-7 here in game four.
Again, Mark, interesting. Canuck Ja popped up that ball short and undecided to just kind of touch it back. Didn't punish him. This time, though, Un was able to win the point, but it almost cost him again. I think his coach, when he goes over to his corner, is going to say, look, if that ball goes high, you've got to do something with it. You can't just touch it back.
Ja with another game point. Great serve that time by Canuck. Ja wins game four, 11-8. He starts off with a nice serve too, Jimmy.
Same thing we saw last game. He's going to at the beginning of this game. That tells you something. He knows how important it is to start good this game, so he's pulling out his weapons that have been working so far this match right away this game.
Oh, beautiful backhand by Ja. As on returned on the forehand, but he stayed deep on what for him is the left side of the table, and that opened up the forehand side for Ja to just drive it down there and take a 2-0 lead.
Let love two. One, two.
Good job by Un getting that ball fast to Ja's forehand, causing him to make a mistake.
Good movement that time by Un. We've noted a couple times, Jimmy, but his footwork is excellent. He was able to get himself over in position deep on the forehand side, come cross court with it on Ja to win that point. And
as importantly, getting that ball out to Ja's wide forehand. That's where he's weakest. You don't want to go into his backhand very often. He's very strong there. Good strategy by On the last 2 points.
Oh, Ja misses the opportunity to kill that point after a couple of great saves by On, including one digging it off the floor with a backhand. Just a beautiful shot.
And it's easy to say now that the point's over, but I wish Ja would have played that one a lot safer, because On was running back. He was in no position to threaten you, and he went for a little too much. You can't miss that shot.
Great game.
Great job by Ja, playing the ball so quick on both sides. Gave On no time to deal with that. What an excellent start to this game by both athletes. A lot of chess going on out there, Mark. You can see the strategy. You can see that On's trying to get the ball out wide to Canuck's forehand. Canuck's trying to get that backhand inside loop wide to On's forehand. You see the serve strategy. There's just so much chess going on out there right now.
That was a good example of going soft, hard, really quickly for both players.
Four, three.
Great job by On there, hanging in that point. Really just reacting to the balls. Watch this right here. Beautiful backhand.
Good save off the top of the net that time by John. He's able to drive that backhand deep into the corner. And there we go again, Jimmy, with the backhand exchange. It does appear that Ja has the advantage over the youngster on.
Here comes the service from Ja. We've seen a lot of deep serves throughout this match. It'll be interesting to see what he does here. Served it deep again and got the point. Unable to deal with the deep serve, but wasn't a strong enough shot. Great decision by Ja. Oh, just fantastic reaction by An. Ja went with the wide, short backhand serve, which has worked several times. Unable to get it, but what a reaction.
It's hard to drive the ball behind this kid. He did a really good job of coming across, making that look easy, getting back on the table. Now at 5-5 in the game, 2-2 in games. That's a let serve. So we'll do that one again.
So that ball clipped the edge. It looked to me like it missed, but they're saying it hit the edge. So a fortunate break there for Ja. He is going to be up 6-5 once the score card changes here. So 6-5 for Ja.
Let. Five, six, net.
Still haven't changed it on our scoreboard, but it is actually 5-6. It was interesting that An made a point of noting that it did hit clip the edge.
And that's a great slow ball there by Ja, changing the pace. An was back from the table trying to go for a big shot. Watch this right here. Watch this shot right here. See, no pace on the ball. That's what won him the point. So this game is not all about speed. You have to know when to play hard and when to play soft. That's a perfect example of it, Mark. Another nice slow play by Ja. He's so good at it. Just took his time, played that ball medium speed at best, gave An nothing to work with.
Opened up his first 3-point lead of this game five.
Oh, fantastic point by both players. But Ja, with the finishing touch on the forehand side. Look at this right here.
Tremendous angle on the finish there, Jimmy. He was able to get it deep onto what would be his left side of the table, the forehand side for An, now 9-5.
Good serve. Yes. He pulled out a new serve. You really haven't seen this whole match.
You can tell An is very happy about that serve too, just by his reaction, his eyes. He watched Ja's reaction as Ja kind of walked around back there. Like it was a bit of a surprise for Ja.
But that was an interesting point. So An went with a similar serve and put a little topspin on it. Ja was clearly uncomfortable with this new serve he's pulled out and made a poor receive. It was so poor though that An wasn't ready for it. Unforced error by An. He's got to make that shot.
Game point for Kanak Ja. Off the net and long,
seven.
Staving off one of the game points is An Jae Hyun of Korean Republic.
And will we see a deep serve? That's the question. We did see the deep serve. Great job by An being ready for it. When you go to the well, the more you go to it, the more likely your opponent is going to start catching on. That time, Un was waiting for it. You could see in his body language. Watch this right here. He's ready for the deep serve. He just carefully put it on the table. He's kept himself in this game.
That was a good look at his footwork, too, to get himself in position to make that return. Now with the serve. Leading off game point three times now is An Jae-hyun of Korea.
Well, Mark, you know, this is what it's all about. If you're going to win tournaments, you're going to either win the 11-9 games and the deuce games, or you're going to lose the games. And so let's see what happens here. I'm threatening to deuce this game. Huge point for both players.
Great shot by Ja on the corner of the table and wins game five. Ja with the advantage right now after five games, 3-2, starting game six in the best of seven.
One love.
Great point there by An, hanging with Ja backhand to backhand. Taking the first point of this game when you were down 3-2 or 3-anything, you want to start good. Another nice rally to start this game, Mark. Ja this time able to hang in there with some good reactions. Look at that great forehand reaction there.
Please don't kick the ball. Please don't kick the ball.
Looks like An's forehand let him down just a little bit right there. He was in position to put that one away, but caught the top of the tape and it didn't fall over. So 1-1 here in game six. Ja up 3-2.
Excellent receive by An there, really putting some juice on that shot. He did not play that passive. A lot of spin, great speed, kept it low to the net. Ja unable to react to it, it was just too fast.
He's pretty happy with himself too there. You can hear his vocalization after winning that point.
There's that wide backhand serve.
Oh, nice step up by Ja to drive it into the body of An and tie this one up at 2-2. I thought that was a let serve at first, but it wasn't called, and I'm guessing it wasn't.
Here it is again. It's the serve that set up that point by Ja. I'm very impressed with Ja's service game as far as strategy this game. He's not coming out with any serves that are too fancy, but his placement's incredible. He's serving deep at the right time. Very impressive.
3-2.
And An says, hey, I can do some good serve strategy myself. How about a short, heavy, spinny serve for the winner?
Hit and out, and now a 2-point advantage for An Jae-hyun. You know, part of bringing the World Table Tennis Championship Finals to America is to introduce a new group of people to the great sport of table tennis, and I'm told that some of my family members who might not otherwise be caught watching table tennis are watching this event right now, so I'm pretty excited about that, Jimmy Butler.
Excellent backhand to backhand rally there. An coming out the winner this time. He takes a step back from the table, watch right here, and then he just starts rallying backhand to backhand. And just too much speed for Ja to handle that point.
Yeah, it's the first real backhand exchange that we've seen An take control of and win. Powerful forehands that time by An Jae-hyun. Opens up a 4-point lead at 6-2. He went to both sides of the table, forehand, then backhand, and not much you can do on that.
An's body acceleration on his forehand is just textbook perfect. Great deep serve by An. totally caught Ja sleeping that time. Ja was not ready for that at all. He had tremendous speed, kept the ball low to the net, and tremendous length. Picture perfect deep serve.
And two. Ja has certainly regrouped here in game six and has now opened up a 6-point lead at 8-2, trying to even things up in the best of seven.
Was a nice stop block by An. Those are called stop blocks, where the player, it's not an offensive shot. They actually stop the ball and put chop on it, and that's why you saw the ball stop. It had no pace. It's also loaded with side spin and backspin.
Real high toss nine, serve that time three. By John. Difficult return for An. He hits it wide.
Well, that's an interesting serve. When you're down 9-2, that's the kind of serve you do. Not so much because Ja's thinking, hey, if I make this serve, maybe I can come back. But he wants An to know, I might serve you down the line deep, even though I know he's not going to do that next game.
9-4.
And I say next game, this game is not over. But to come back from 9-3 is very rare. Very rare to come back, but anything's possible. We've seen it happen before.
Now to game point, multiple game points for the Korean An Jae-hyun. It's Kanak Ja out of Milpitas, California. Quite a force in American table tennis for a while.
5-10.
A rare unforced error by An this game. He's played pretty much a perfect game. Oh, that actually hit.
Wow, what a way to go out by An Jae-hyun. Great shot down the line. Did go with a long serve there, and it's kind of like whether you're going to throw a curveball or a fastball, you get the batter thinking, if nothing else.
I love that choice. I mean, that's risky. You just serve deep and it went let, and you do it again. I love it. Go for it. Do the unexpected. Be different. Another deep serve. Oh, and that beautiful backhand down the line from Ja. That's been his go-to shot this whole match. Here it is right here, right there. You see how he turns that racket angle and goes inside down the line. Fantastic shot by Ja to go up 2-0.
Oh, great exchange between both players, and it's Ja reaching high up into the air to drive it behind on the finish.
Look at this body movement right here by Ja. Just that turn of the waist was fantastic. And you saw the fist pump he did to his coach, Stefan Feth, after that point. And then he tried to stay calm, calmed himself down. Here we go. Great job by An to get on the board. There is no worse feeling than when you're in game seven and you start losing point one, point two, point three. You want to stop the bleeding as soon as possible, and he did it there.
Bit of everything in that one, and the ball goes long off the paddle of An, and Ja takes a 4-1 lead. Touch, power, a little bit of every type of shot possible. Digging it off the floor again was An, but his touch shot at the end goes deep.
And he started with a deep serve, and I'm now interested to see if he goes wide, short to the backhand. Just kind of starting to get used to his patterns. Let's see what he does here. That time he served short to the middle, a very careful and safe serve, and it did not pay off. Unhandled that serve without a problem and was able to put pressure on Ja early in the point. Watch this right here, a nice slow opening, and then that quick backhand to his middle. Here we see it again, right to his middle, that's what won on the point.
Draws within one as that ball goes long.
And I love that opening by Un. It's very careful, played the ball safe and spinning on the table, gave Ja nothing to work with. Ja was not expecting such a slow opening. Threw off his timing.
Two very strategic players going head to head here. Game seven, round 128. Here Kanak Ja say sorry. His shot went off the net and it caused a misfire from On into the net. And now Ja reopens the lead at 2-5-3 here in game seven.
That ball just barely touched the top of the net, Mark.
That's all it takes,
right,
isn't it, Jerry? I mean,
it's all it takes.
It's just a little bit of change. It doesn't have to be that dramatic because you're anticipating one thing and your body is set. Not anticipating that it's gonna just slow just a little bit, maybe change direction.
Let's see what Ja serves here. There's that wide backhand serve. Oh, what a great rally. Ja able to hang in that point and regain positioning at the table, came close to the table, but Un with just beautiful reactions. Watch this right here. Un with a great backhand, hanging backhand to backhand, and then got Ja to make a mistake.
Both players in beautiful form here. Game seven, 5-4 lead for Ja with the serve. Turn by Kanak Ja as he was able to get out and block back onto the table. And you can tell by his vocal reaction that he's pretty pleased with himself there.
Well, that is Kanak Ja at his best. He can make incredible defensive shots. You are never sure if that ball's coming back or not until it hits the ground.
The edge. Draw within one. We've seen a good a number of those kind of fortunate breaks go in both directions, so it's about 50-50 right now.
Caught the edge back. Draw with that.
It's 51-49 now.
Here we go again, watch this right here. Good backhand opening, and then catches the edge wide to Un's forehand.
Reopening the 2-point lead, Kanak Ja, and you can tell both players on virtually every point we've seen in this game seven, they've had to acknowledge a bit of a fortuitous break, and shows you the margin for error very slim in this sport.
There's that wide backhand serve, and it wins in the point. Great decision by Ja there to do that wide backhand short serve. It caught Un off guard. He had to put up a weak receive. Ja able to finish the point.
That time for On, and he drives it long, and now Ja opens up the 4-point lead at 9-5 here in the decisive game seven. You can see Ja talking to himself and calming himself down.
On coming back with that serve we talked about, that new reverse pendulum serve that he did in the previous game. Let's see if he does it again here. There it is. Oh, beautiful follow. And Ja is very, very unsure about the serve. Watch this receive. He just puts it back. He doesn't know what to do with it. And Ahn punishes him.
Nice step around forehand that time by Ahn.
There it is again.
Oh, what a great shot by Janak Ja. Another block across the table to draw the game point.
And that is Ja's strength, is he can make shots like that. One of the best defenders in the world.
That goes long, so Ahn staves off one game point here. You knew it wasn't gonna be easy. Not with this kid.
See what Ja serves here. Will he serve deep? Will he go short and wide to the backhand? Here we go.
Oh, what a great point to win the match on for Janak Ja. Both players, tremendous exchange, and the American is gonna advance to the round of 64 with a 7-game win over the Korean Ahn Jae-hyun.